clothes to sew a basic top using auto sewing in Closed3D, I'm going to first import a DXF pattern into Clo. To do so, I'm going to come over here to File, Done, select Import, and then select DXF parentheses AAMA/ASTM parentheses. Click on it to select Done. This will allow me to navigate to my pattern file, which is download. Then basic top, I'm going to click on it to open the folder. And as we can see here, we have EF woman basic top. And by the way, guys, if you are new to download file from Etsy, be sure to unzip the folder first before you can open Wear Clothes, okay? So right here, the zip file is grayed out, which means I can't open it. And I can open this folder, which I already unzipped, okay? So I'm going to double click on that folder to open. And as you can see, the folder right there has three files. .csv, which is the specs file. Then .pdf, which is the file for if you want to open that pattern with Adobe Illustrator. Or in this case, we want to open .dxf, which is we can open that in Clo 3D. So all we need to do here, click on that file and then come over here to open, click on it. This will bring this import DXF window and load type we want it open, scale millimeter, and this is important, we want that to be 100%. After that, rotation, do not rotate, and option. We want to check import pattern annotation, auto trace as internal lines, swap cutting line and sewing line, include notches. After that, I'm going to come down here, click on OK. There it is. So this is what it looks like, that the pattern that we just imported. And as we can see right here, this annotation right there, if somehow your doesn't show the annotation part, I will come over here. You see this information icon, and in there you have this letter A icon active. If somehow your isn't, be sure to check that to turn it off and check that one again to turn it back on. Now you see the annotation appear onto the garment. Next, we want to load the avatar. So once again, if you are new to Clo, come over here to this library and then double click on this avatar window to open the avatar. Then you can click on this female_v2 to open more avatar, and you will find like Camilla, Fei. So if you 6.1, you will see Camilla avatar right here. Or you can select Emma, which is also V2 avatar, or Fei, however you like. However, I'm going to select my own custom avatar, which is over here that I already import the avatar in Clo. So if you guys want to customize your own avatar, I have the video links below. So check it out. It's quite easy, guys. You don't have to leave Clo anymore to customize your avatar. It's so simple. Okay, so now I'm going to click on that folder, my avatar folder. And so right here, I do not only have my avatar customized, and I also have sizes for that avatar. So for this example, I'm going to select woman extra small avatar. So I'm going to double click on her to load it. Okay, so now we just load this avatar onto Clover Space. I'm going to pan the avatar to the right a little bit by pressing down Option and Alt and left click. Then I'm going to zoom in just a little bit because we want to see a little bit closer. Okay, now you have a designista. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you find this video useful on how to use auto sewing function in Clover with this basic top. And remember to sub and click on the bell for more awesome videos. Thank you.